James is going to speak about his piece. Please, just go right in for me.
I'd like to add to something that Tom said before. Lechatitsky, one of his students was Schnabel. One of his students was Ruth Lenjinska, and she wrote Sex and Lessons with Lenjinska. So the line is here tonight. For me, this all came about when my wife asked me for a piano piece. And my first thought was, what will happen to my marriage? you put somebody on my shoulder in writing the piece, and a lot of things I think I would let go, I couldn't, thinking that, you know, she's got to like the piece, not a thought that I would normally have in writing the piece. I was also inspired by the fact that she had told me that Scarlatti had written most of his piano sonatas, over 100, harpsichord sonatas, for the Portuguese princess, who was his harpsichord student, between the ages of 70 and 75, which I found kind of remarkable and inspiring as I undertook this. The piece ends with a fugue, and the fugue undoubtedly comes from my memory of the Stravinsky Concerto for Two Solo Pianos, which I played. It made a very effective ending in this piece, and I'm sure I was influenced by it. And I'm just going to give them Stravinsky when you get through. The ending of that really got me at the time. Stravinsky wrote that piece, I think, in 1932. And so I had the idea that I took it to Stravinsky and that I would finish with a fugue. But I would update the fugue somewhat. And so here's the ending of my piece. Sit down. Writing the other parts, the shortness of it was always on my mind. And I remembered from music history class the term before Bach from Renaissance time for a short fugue is Attacco. Then you could have a short fugue, you could have a long fugue, and you could have a double short fugue, which is a long fugue. So, that's why the title Attacco is there. And belle has two different meanings, and you can pick either one. One means pretty, and the other means southern belle. So, fugue girl. Hope you enjoy it.